Greetings, minions! I am your humble nerd, Cyrus Thinker, and I'm just here with some more Let's Play Game of Thrones, the Telltale Adventure. Let's go! Slightly hard to have an energy drink at the moment, but,
I love King's Landing in the afternoon. The sun just barely kisses your skin. You used to love this place.
Yeah, until it stopped me.
Remember, we'd come listen to the musicians in the evening with Lady Marjorie.
You're right. It's beautiful here.
You sound any more insincere, love?
Just through here.
Just through here. This is where you're gonna get jumped and raped.
What are you doing? You'll see.
You'll see when we get jumped and raped.
Queen Cersei's finest wine.
Wait, what? Wait, what? You stole the queen's wine.
I hope you've got another one of those.
I never took you for a lush, Mira. Sadly, it's just the one. A little won't hurt.
Besides, we're both fucked if we get caught.
So,
Could just hide that right now. Why don't you just keep it hidden until you're taking a drink?
Well, I just...
Is this where you admit to being a lesbian? Do it!
I'm not very good at this sort of thing.
Wait, no, this isn't what you actually do.
Listen, if I tell you this...
This can't be what's going on right now. It's almost certainly not.
You can tell no one.
I swear, I won't tell a soul.
And you can trust me, I'm a slightly weird-shaped head.
My mother was a handmaiden to Lady Elena for many years.
Oh, the funny one.
She became pregnant. It was a disgrace to her family. My true name is Sarah Flowers.
You're a bastard?
Yes.
Yeah, just say it out loud, why don't you?
I'm fortunate to be where I am. I know that.
Was your mother from a noble house? She must have been, to serve Lady Elena.
Yes, though it's not well known. Distant cousins of the Tywells, I'm told. They wanted nothing to do with me after my mother died.
Well, they're friendly, aren't they?
I'm so sorry, Sarah.
It's just... I don't want to be Sarah Flowers forever.
Fair
I
enough.
I need Lady Marjorie to arrange a marriage for me.
You can't possibly
it's
be...
It's my chance at a life.
Have you tried asking Lady Marjorie?
Because I can't ask her for something else.
I can simply ask for. I need her favor first. I know she often confides in you, and I was hoping that maybe...
I could fucking break
sometime when
confidence.
She comes to you wanting to talk, you might suggest she talk to me instead. Give me a chance to win her over. Coming from you, it's sure to mean a lot.
I can't make that promise, Sarah.
You could if you wanted.
Well, are you being a dick about
it's
this?
It's not that difficult.
I have much bigger problems, Sarah. I need to look out for my family.
No. You're right. I'm sure I would want to look after my family, too. I know your family's troubles are much greater than mine.
Yeah, burnt face, cripple, brother dead.
Your father.
Actually, I'm wondering, does she know that her brother's dead already?
You need this more than I do.
Wow, thanks.
A conspiracy of handbags.
Lord Tyrion.
My lord.
Ladies. What have we here?
Wine.
If you mean to drink from that flagon, you're going about it the wrong way.
Care to join us, Lord Tyrion?
Not the finest arbor red, but a favorite of my sister's.
Quite
expensive for a handmaiden.
Don't worry, no.
I'd be curious to know how you got hold of it. Since I'm certain my sister didn't give it to you, she won't even share with me.
I took the wine from the cellars.
Aren't you full of surprises? I suggest bringing cups next time. There are risks worth taking, Stealing wine from the Queen Regent isn't one of them. Especially if you wish to have an alliance with me.
I'd have argued it is.
Things have changed.
Just to piss off the Queen Regent.
My father has recently taken an interest in Ironwood. Most of the Royal Navy went up in green flames.
That was a while ago, wasn't it? That was like a season ago.
Rebuilt. He insisted I handle things myself.
Really? He gave
I'm
you responsibility?
I'm on my way to meet representatives of Lord Whitehill.
Lord Whitehill?
He's hired a pair of merchant lords to broker for his house. It would seem Lord Whitehill wishes to sell the Ironwood right out from beneath your family. I don't know much about the man, but judging by his up-jumped sellswords...
I will speak for House Forrester.
Perhaps you could.
If you hadn't just stolen wine, love.
Come with me. These men think I have no choice but to deal with them. Imagine their surprise when I bring a Forrester to the table.
It'll piss him off.
It might be the first fun I've had in months.
Really? Do you not visit brothels that often anymore? Oh no, wait, you're still with Shay at this point, aren't you? Because you haven't shot your father with a crossbow yet. But, yeah, no. Fine, let's go. Oh, fuck it, Glog, you're gone.
We've been waiting here for an hour.
Andros, be courteous.
Courtesy in a merchant. Like finding gold in your chamber pot.
Huh.
Apologies, my lady.
Who is this?
It's a normal
looking...
Some girl
you brought for entertainment.
My name is Mira Forrester.
Mira Forrester?
Yes, I'm a forester. The person whose shit
you're
trying to sell.
A fair question.
We were told we would be speaking to Lord Tyrion alone.
I'm here to sell our Ironwood, my lord.
Oh, really?
Andros. I'm sorry, Lady Mira, but we've already spoken to Lord
you
Tyrion.
You spoke, I listened. Lady Mira has since persuaded me to consider her offer first. Now, if you'll excuse us.
You're going to dismiss
You can't do this.
Yes, he can.
I assure you, I can.
He's
this is a mistake, my lord.
Tyrion's the master of coin. He can do whatever the fuck he wants, regardless of finances.
We'll hear of this.
Oh, Lord Whitehill can go.
He's not a man to take such matters lightly. Lord Tyrion.
My god, okay.
Lord Tyrion.
There's one problem.
Let me know when you've come to a decision. I'd like the opportunity to change your mind. Lady Mira.
Good day, gentlemen.
Okay, if there's one problem I have with the way that this is being written, it's the fact that everyone is really insolent to people
now,
seemingly above them.
Offer. What did you have in mind?
I haven't had a chance to think this
My
over.
Lord.
The Crown's Ironwood. I assume you have a proposition?
Give me fucking the choices and I'll think of one.
You had a reason for coming here. I know it wasn't just to entertain me.
I'm sure you already have a proposal in mind.
You are
the
master of coin.
Agrees to buy Ironwood solely from you. Lord Whitehill will be left in the cold. If he wishes to sell to the Crown, he'll have to do so through your family. You will have him at your mercy. Or you'll bring your houses to open war. You do know that's a possibility, don't you?
Then that's a risk I'll have to take.
That's another problem I have with this. Is everyone, all of the like known actors' faces are a bit too smooth
I'll
when they've been rendered in this.
The arrangement.
That's not really a proposal, is it?
Of course, you'd have to do something for me in return.
Okay, no.
Don't worry. The terms will be fair.
What is it you want?
You'll know soon enough.
Okay, great. Blank
have
check.
An understanding, then.
Love it.
Thank you, my lord.
This will either be very good for both of us, or very bad for you.
Yeah.
For your sake, I hope it's the former.
Wait, if it's very bad for her, what effect does it have on you, Tyrion? Fucking
my
none!
Lady.
Okay, thank you. One line. Lannister Guardsman, thank you. That's good. I mean, that guy probably got steak dinner for that line, but still. Oh, that blood must fucking reek in this heat. I say this heat, I mean like the heat of Yunkai. One sellsword company appears to be everywhere, doesn't it? I suppose they are looking for, like, the one, like, the two white guys in Yunkai, and, like, the one female whose face is covered in scars. Oh, shit. Bit late flattening yourself.
Headed for the main gate.
I know another way.
Do you?
You're coming with us, then.
If you're to save your house, you'll need more than the two of us at your side. You'll need an army.
That's why you're here, isn't it? To hire one.
An army of sellswords.
Can't trust sellswords.
And a man to lead them. Do you hear what I'm saying, boy?
I can lead an army.
I know you can. I've always known it. Basically, your father was blind to that.
Basically, the only thing you're good for.
That matters without sellswords to hire. And all the companies around here are engaged.
What about Croft?
One-eyed Croft, with the second sons. They're all with the Targaryen girl now.
But Croft owes me a favor.
I'm pretty sure he hates you, actually.
No. He'll help us. I'll make sure of it.
I'll make sure he hates me.
How are you going to do that? We didn't part on the best of terms.
I'll be charming.
Right.
Yeah, this is not... Yeah, because this isn't, like, crazy suspicious.
Well, this mother of dragons and her sellswords are headed north, so we make for Meereen.
Wait, Meereen? Shit.
What?
Unfinished business there. I don't want to talk about it.
So that's why I
can't afford any distractions.
It's not your problem. It'll be fine.
What kind of unfinished business?
The kind I'd rather keep to myself.
Well, then you can't come then, love.
Ponte Renas. Yunkai Heronchos, Ibota con Costoti Daor.
Okay, sorry. The accents on these SLC chaps, and these Giskari, is a bit strange. It's weird. Very roly R's. Don't look at me. Don't look at me. Don't look at me. Don't do it. Don't do it, mate. Don't do it, love. Yeah, that dude's clearly blind. Then again, given the helmet he's wearing, it's fair enough.
Just one more we'll have to kill later.
Let's go.
You did well back there, Asher.
Yeah.
You acted like a true leader.
Really?
You two can talk about it later.
She has a point.
We need to get out of here.
Yes, we do.
They won't stop looking for us.
Okay, why is it that apparently
it's a
the entire...
long journey to Meereen on foot. I hope you're ready, Asher.
Well,
it won't be easy.
Let's just get that army. I'm ready.
Good lad. Either we cross the narrow sea with an army at our backs, or House Forrester will not survive to see winter.
I thought winter was already happening. Oh no, wait, it's autumn, I think, at this point. Maybe that's just in the books, it's autumn at this point. I don't know, I keep getting mixed up with like exactly how far through this the books are. Or rather, how far through the... How far the show is through the books, I mean. Open door. Don't trust it. Always suspicious of an open door. It's like in Shadow. It's like never trust an open door. It's like in Shadowrun, never cut a deal with a dragon. Never cut a deal with an open door. Or rather, a door that shouldn't be open, shall I say. Yep, get into a battle pose, even though you've got no, like, weapons or anything, love. That'll be fine. Bust it. Okay, that's not creepy at all. Fucking ransacked my desk. Look at the chest, what's going on?
Everything's still here.
Okay, so someone ransacked your letters but didn't steal your stuff. Good.
The letters from my family. What would someone want with them?
I don't know, see exactly what you and your family have been talking about. What's going on with the book? Couldn't quite catch that.
Was someone going through my books?
Looks like it, love, given the fact that there's a book on the floor. Unless you're just a pig. I don't really know.
I have information that will aid you with the imp. Meet me in the gardens at midnight.
Ah, would that be that Lannister guard? It's either the Coalboy or it's the Lannister guard. It's got to be one of the two.
There.
Ah, the Blue Fire's
guard. That should last through Lady Elena's visit, at least.
There's been no news from Mira. She may not have found a way to help with Elena.
Oh, thank God! Someone got him a cane.
Ray, you're right. Lord Glenmore's army could keep us from ruin. But Elena must still agree to the marriage.
My lord. You might remind Lady Elena that in terms of lineage, you are still very much a man.
Maester.
What I mean is, if the two of you wanted to produce an heir...
That was never in question.
Of course not. I just meant...
Enough, Maester.
Oh, imagine...
When you spoke of Elena, you said you'd push to get her father's army. And so you must.
Good lord, imagine actually trying to broach...
that you'll want to see gentleness in you too.
Imagine trying to broach that topic with her. By the way, I've still got a functioning dick.
But this is an important day for all of us.
Thank you, Mother. This advice well taken.
I'm just so glad to see you home.
Oh god, why are people sending me fucking...
She's here.
Dude, sending me Skype messages already on my fucking phone. Fucking emails, what the hell, why now? In the middle of recording. No, go away, fucking Facebook. Ah, there she is, hello. New character, I can't recognize. Try not to look at...
You look...
I know, I'm unspeakably handsome.
I see you haven't lost your sense of humor.
No, just two limbs and half a face. Please.
Please, it'll give me an excuse to sit down as well. Like I was like, he's been up for 10 seconds, he's already sitting down.
Here we are.
How have you been, Elena?
Oh, it's been quiet, I suppose. Times have certainly been difficult, but I'm well. Thank you for asking.
Ask me how I've
set
been.
Out for Iron Wrath as soon as I heard you were alive. My father suggested I wait, but I can't believe it's been 2 years.
Your brother's name day feast. We danced until the sun came out.
Must have been fucking knackered by the end of that.
But now your house prepares for a funeral. And you... Tell me the truth, Roderick. How are you, really?
Ah, she did ask how I am.
And please, be honest with me. I don't mean to pry, but...
I won't lie. Every day's a battle.
I can only imagine...
Please don't. I'm supposed to be impressive.
So much has changed since we were children. Playing hide-and-seek in the grove.
Oh, is that what they call it?
So easy to find. You always hid behind the same tree.
Maybe I wanted you to find me.
Must be kind of creepy. Like,
but Roderick. I need to ask you something.
Is this going
to
be about my dick?
When I arrived at Iron Wrath today... Your courtyard was filled with drunken soldiers. White Hill soldiers. They said some terrible things. The White Hills are your oldest enemies, Roderick. Why are they here? Has something happened?
Trust me. They won't be here long.
That wasn't an answer.
Wish could have picked a different one. Oh, don't stare at fires, please.
I'm going to be honest with you, Roderick. I have always looked forward to our marriage.
But now you're a cripple, fuck it.
But in light of all that's happened to your family... My father is questioning the wisdom of our betrothal. And I was inclined to agree with him, until I received a curious letter from Marjorie Tyrell.
What did it say?
Lady Marjorie suggests in the kindest of terms that we go through with the marriage. And as you can imagine, a suggestion from a future queen is difficult to ignore.
Oh, that letter actually got sent.
Do you know why Lady Marjorie would send this to me? She and I have never corresponded.
House Forrester still has many powerful allies.
Including the Tyrells, apparently.
Apparently.
I don't know what favors you had to call in, but I feel manipulated, Roderick. A house like mine can't refuse a suggestion from Marjorie Tyrell. I'm being forced to marry you, Roderick. Is that truly what you want? Would you do that to me? After everything we've shared?
Of course not, Elena. You're free to choose.
Thank you. I was afraid you'd refuse to back down, but you must care about me more than that. Let us stand together, Roderick. I will tell my father our betrothal stands.
Sorry, I've just, like, lifted my arms in the air with a whoop.
The rumors are true.
Oh, for fuck's sake, Whitehill!
You have no right to just...
And if it isn't Elena Glenmore? You're not still marrying into this wretched family.
Our houses will be joined, in fact. And we will stand proudly beside them.
Can I change your mind?
Yes, you are.
You do much better than this cripple.
Get out. Now.
How rude of you. Your mother's the one who invited me here.
That's not true. I sent a raven to Lord Whitehill about letting Brian attend the funeral. But I never expected him to barge in like this.
Oh, she practically begged me to.
Yeah, because everyone's paying attention to what you're saying.
The same in her position. The youngest son home to mourn his dead father and brother.
Ryan belongs at that funeral. This family.
Not until I'm certain that you know your place. Lord Ramsay ordered your family to obey my soldiers until my son Griff arrives from Harrenhal. But now I hear you're ordering them around and keeping them dull on wine. It makes me start to question your obedience.
Lud. Enough of this.
I do not have to obey.
See? That's just the kind of arrogance I'm talking about. So, here's the idea. We're going to make a fresh start, you and I. Your brother Ethan called me Craven, but you're a different man entirely, aren't you? So, if you want Ryan at that funeral, sure, Lady Elena, you respect your betters. Kneel and kiss my shiny ring.
Just do it, Roderick.
You don't want to end up like your brother, do you?
Please. It means nothing, and we'll get to see Ryan again.
Go on. Get on your knees. Kiss it.
No, fuck you.
I'm not kissing your ring. Do what you must.
Fine. I'll just tell Ryan you didn't want to see him.
No, please.
And because of your defiance, I'm taking what should have been mine in the first place. The other half of the Ironwood Forest.
You can't do
Ramsay
that.
Snow,
I know what Ramsay said. I'm saying something else. As of today, I harvest Ironwood from wherever the fuck I please. And you can't do a bloody thing to stop me.
Would you defy an express order from House Bolton?
I've known Roose Bolton my whole life. As long as he gets his ironwood, he won't care. Well, I have what I came for. I'll leave you to your business. Oh, by the way, my men have a name for you. Roderick the Ruined. Isn't that clever?
Not really. Kind of one of the... My God! Fucking Facebook and shit going mental at me.
He's gonna make things difficult for both of us, isn't he? I'm glad you didn't let him humiliate you.
You'd put your pride ahead of your family. What's poor Ryan going to think? That we've abandoned him?
We can't afford to show weakness, Mother.
It would have been a minor sacrifice.
Is In the politics of lords and kings and fuckers who have shit tons of armies, weakness is preyed upon. That's how it works.
My lord.
Oh, God damn it, Roy.
Are you well?
About as well as a man with half a face. Can be.
I'm going to kill that man.
Damn right we are, mate. Damn fucking right we are. Either that or he's going to kill us. Honestly, so far, I'm willing to say that he's probably going to kill us. Okay, 25 minutes in. That's going to have to be the end of another video. So, that's going to have to be all for me for now. I've been your humble nerd, Cyrus Thinker, and as always, keep calm and carry on. Good day. So, I hope you enjoyed watching that video as much as I enjoyed making it. Let's be honest, I'm not kidding anyone. I don't know if I enjoyed it. I'm a pre-recorded message. Regardless, if you did enjoy it, please like the video, subscribe to my channel, and leave a comment below. I do read every comment I get. I need some form of validation for spending as much time as I do making these fucking things. If you want to see more of my stuff, please have a look around my channel. I've been making videos for years now, so there is a lot of content to see. I also try to upload once a day, 5 days a week, often with some side stuff going on over the weekend, so you may want to check that out. If you wish, you can follow me on Twitter, where I've been known to post inane bullshit on a semi-regular basis, and if you're feeling particularly generous, you can always subscribe to my Patreon campaign. Every subscriber on there brings me closer to not having to get off my fat ass and get a real job. And I'll eventually be able to upgrade my PC and all that shit. Well, that's it for this pre-recording. Hope to see you all in the next video. Now, get the fuck out. This one's over. Leave. Now.